Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. It's iHogan22 here, and today's video we're going to reacting to the new Rainbow Six Siege season, which is called Neon Dawn. Ubisoft have just released the new trailer for the new season Neon Dawn, so we're just going to give my thoughts and opinions on what that new season looks like, what it's going to bring to the new season, and just where we're going to go from here. And as always guys, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like and comment down below, turn that notification bell on, and let's just get straight into the video.
Operation Neon Dawn is lighting up Rainbow Six Siege in a whole new way, as a defender named Aruni is setting up laser gates. Angry laser gates. Look, I know they seem cool and kinda synth-wavy, but attackers, please don't touch them. I promise you it's for your own good. These gates have it out for drones, utility projectiles, and anyone on the attacking team, making Aruni a powerful architect of defense. Neon Dawn is also bringing a skyscraper map rework, as well as some key gameplay updates, including a nice little upgrade to Hibana's ex-Kairos launcher. Follow this channel and keep watching for more on the new season that's really going to punch above its weight.
Right guys, so first things first, the new defensive operator called Aruni looks incredible. I wasn't sure if we were going to get another defensive operator or if we were going to get like another attacking operator. So I know Zero was the last character released, so it just seemed sort of back-to-back attacking operators. But the defense now, probably one of the biggest concerns about most pro players and things like that, is the defense already has so much utility that the attacking operators are more sort of spending their time burning through and things like that, that we didn't expect another defensive operator that was going to be similar to that, and it looks like it is. So what Aruni looks like, just from the quick sort of intro there from the video, is that she's got laser gates, which basically stop all projectiles, and also do a bit of damage as well when you sort of go through it. So it's a kind of a bit like a Capcan trap that is really visible, but you have to get rid of it to go through it, and you can't just shoot it. So that's what the sort of the new operator looks like to start off with before we go into more detail of her. And then also, thank goodness, there's a new map rework, which is Skyscraper. I have to say, playing the new season at the minute, because of the map bans and things like that, although that is incredible and I love the map bans, you are now all of a sudden just playing the same 3, 4, 5 maps constantly. There's not a massive variation in it now. Sometimes our team just sort of ban a map that we like just to play when we don't like, just because we've not played it in a while. So it's good that another map is going to be thrown back into the rotation. And Skyscraper, I didn't hate it, the old Skyscraper, I have to say. I didn't love it. It did have quite a lot of flaws. So hopefully, what they've done to the new Skyscraper to rework it, it is going to make it a lot better map, and it's going to bring an extra map into the rotation pool for us to all enjoy.
Aruni is a medium speed, medium armor defender from Thailand. She can slow down, stymie, and seriously singe attackers with her Surya Gates. She can drape them over a soft or reinforced wall, set them up on windows, or use them to protect hatches, and they will completely cover the area. When she deploys them over doors, however, they leave a gap at the bottom for drones or nicely aimed projectiles. Attackers will need to take advantage of that gap because the laser grid of a Surya Gate will destroy any drone or utility projectile that hits it. And if an attacker touches it, it'll take a substantial bite out of their health. See, when a Surya Gate destroys something or zaps someone, it deactivates temporarily to recharge. So, once an attacker uses some utility like a grenade or a gadget, or burns some of their health to take down a Surya Gate, that doorway is just a doorway again.
So guys, just from that little bit of information that we've seen there on Aruni, so she's a medium speed, medium arm operator, which is good. I was slightly worried that maybe she'd be like a new roaming operator, being sort of 3 speed and 1 armor, but she's not. She's 2 speed, 2 armor, so she's going to be, you know, you'll be able to hear her sneaking up on you, for example, so which is quite good. So from the looks of it, I think she has 3, if I'm not mistaken, of her gates, of her laser gates. So not too bad. However, just by the looks of this sort of extra minute that we've just watched there, they're very, very, very versatile. They go on windows, doors, walls, hatches, anything that's reinforced or unreinforced, they attach to. which is a lot. You know, that's almost any single surface that is not an indestructible surface you can almost put them on. That's going to be massive, especially things like hatches and things like that, because you're going to have to waste, again, this is just another extra bit of utility that the attacking team is going to have to work through to try and get into anywhere near the objective. Well, it's taking away flexibility. You're going to have to bring a Sophia and an Ash. You're going to have to bring at least 6 to 9 flashbangs, because you've got 3 of her gates to deal with just to sort of burn up utility, and that's not even including the ADS, the WMIs, things like that. So again, slightly worrying the fact that it's another utility based defences operator that the attack has to use their utility just to get onto the objective. That's probably my only worry. So on the other standpoint though, on the defensive standpoint, she looks really good. She looks really viable. So obviously she's going to help waste time, burn that attacking operator's utility. She's got the P10 Roni, which is a really good SMG as well. So she looks like she's going to be a really solid operator for the defensive team. And then gates are going to come in handy, you know, even if you're deploying them mid-round. You don't necessarily have to have them all out at the start of the round. As it sort of touches on there, that can be on your own rotation between sight, just to give you an extra layer of protection. So she looks like she's going to be really, really viable for the defensive team. She looks like a massive positive defense-wise, but attacking-wise, she's just going to be another operator you're going to have to waste some of your utility to get through.
Keep in mind that there is a short delay from zapping something to deactivation. This short delay is all Aruni needs to get her speedy P10 Roni submachine gun or her big bad Mk14 EBR marksman rifle trained on the door in question.
Right, just stopping it there really quickly as well. So it looks that she's got the Mk14 as a defensive operator, which is massive. I mean, I think the biggest change we saw to guns switching from, you know, the attacking side to the defensive side or vice versa was just recently with Zero. He got the MP7, which is Bandit's normal SMG gun. He got that as an attacking operator. And now it looks like that it's gone the other way now, and one of the attacking operators, a DMR for example, has been swapped from the attacking team to the defensive team. So she's got the MK14. I don't know how viable that's going to be compared to the Roni, because as a defensive operator, most of the time, you're not going to be challenging long, far angles like you would an attacking operator. You're not going to be sort of holding an angle into sight, or you're not going to be holding a flank watch or something like that. So the MK14 will be used a lot less than the Roni. I know that for a fact, but it is still it's still a really decent gun, especially for a DMR. It's got, the fire rate's not amazing, but it's okay. You can get a few bullets away quite quickly with it. And obviously it hits like a tank, hence the whole point of it being a DMR. So I wouldn't say it's going to be game-changing that she's got that weapon in per se. Like I said, I think 90% of people would play the Roni weapon SMG anyway. But it is a massive change, and it would be interesting to see how that's going to work, having a gun like that on the defensive team.
The first DMR to be wielded by a defender is not to be taken lightly. And Aruni always has her PRB-92 sidearm standing by for close encounters. Influencing where encounters happen is one of Aruni's biggest strengths, as her Surya Gates help the defending team reconfigure the map to their advantage. You see, while attackers get hung up dealing with laser problems, defenders can waltz right through. The Surya Gate turns off when a defender is close, making them perfect for protecting your rotation holes. Just be careful not to set up an ambush too close to one while an attacker is nearby, or you may give your position away by turning off the gate. Even if the attackers do shut down a gate, Surya Gate generators are indestructible, but while the gate will recharge, it won't reactivate automatically. Defenders will have to wait until the sparking effect stops and the generator flips open again. Then they'll have to shoot it to get the grid back online. And if Aruni ever decides to shift her defensive focus, the generators can be picked up and repositioned at will.
Right, so just really quickly, some more information on her gadget with that one. So first of all, they can be moved, which is, it's okay. I understand the point of it, especially if you've set up all three of them, let's just say, for a front take, and all of a sudden you find out that all 5 attacking operators are pushing the back way, and you want to quickly pick them up and switch them around. I get that. However, it looks quite strong. And the fact that also you're coupling that with the fact that they're indestructible gadgets, which apart from maybe, I mean, I would say something like a Maestro can, but that is destructible. You have to get a sort of a way around it with an explosive or something. But from the looks of this, even with explosives, it's indestructible. I don't know if you need that, coupled with the fact that they're also movable. Again, she looks like she's going to be really, really strong coming out of the gate straight away, and that she might even receive, you know, a nerf after a few weeks, month, or whatever. So, I mean, I get the point of its indestructibility, because an operator could just sort of lay down, if it was on a window, for example, operator can lay down on the floor, shoot it, and it's deactivated. I get the fact that it's not, it shouldn't be destructible per se, and you've got to use utility to get through it. However, then it being movable, I'm not too sure on that. I don't know if that's a bit too strong for what the operator needs and what the gadget actually does. So from the looks of it then, when it gets deactivated, it sparks. So I think he said 30 seconds, if I'm not wrong. And then you can shoot it again, and then it'll reactivate. So you will have to, I quite like that standpoint. It doesn't just activate again straight away. That's amazing. You actually need the defending operating team to be aware of what their surroundings are, and need to be aware of which gate has been deactivated, and for them to then reactivate it again. So I like that standpoint. I like things that make the game as interactive as possible. I don't like passive things that are, like I said, you just plop it down, it does its job, catches stuff, then reactivates when it wants. I like the fact that you have to physically reactivate it, which looks good, and also it blocks all projectiles. So if you're a Legion, Valkyrie, you can't just throw a camera or a Legion mine through it. It actually will catch that as well, so it catches everything, which again is just being fair. Then if it's going to catch everything on the attacking team, it should catch everything on the defensive team as well. I also really, really like the animation for defensive operators passing through it. I thought maybe it would just be a case that as a defensive operator you just didn't take damage from sort of jumping through it, but it actually deactivates when you get close to it for you to go through it, which is really nice. I mean, it'd been a bit lazy on the part of the dev team just to sort of have it where defensive operators could just sort of walk on through. So it's nice that again there's some sort of interaction with it where you go close to it, it deactivates, you jump on through. So again, really nice, and I imagine that some people might even play with that. For example, if flashbangs are being thrown in inside the objective, maybe people might stand close to it so all the flashbangs come through, and as soon as you hear all three flashbangs come through, you then quickly move away from the gate again so then it reactivates. So there'll be a bit of sort of like playing around with it and sort of a certain maybe degree of strats or things like that based off of them. So again, any gadget that makes the game more interactive, makes them more interaction between an offensive and a defensive operator, I will be up for.
The power of the Surya Gates to disrupt attackers' plans and movements, plus the added barbed wire or proximity alarms in her secondary gadget slot, make Aruni a formidable asset to any defending team. Oh, and one more thing. You've seen that Aruni's prosthetics give her melee attack a little extra flair, but on the test server, she'll have some extra destructive power as well. PC players can download the test server for free and take Aruni's wall-bustin' left hook for a spin. Just be sure to send the dev team some feedback and let them know what you think.
Okay guys, there, so just to finish off with Aruni, so she's also, as an even added extra, she uses her prosthetic arm to punch quite significant holes through walls. It's not like a peak hole, it's quite a sort of head size hole through sort of destructible walls. So she'll be used first of all, especially on things like Pro League and things, she'll be used for rotations. It looks like she only needs to sort of do like a five, sort of four punches in a square to make something you could be able to vault through. So again, it looks like she can get the punches off quite quickly as well, just as quick as you maybe could knife. Again, just brings even more and more utility to an operator that already seems quite strong. So she's got the power of making rotates, like I said, just punch holes in certain walls to maybe create new lines of sight and things like that. So again, not something that I would say from everything else that she has that she absolutely needs. It looks like a bit of an added extra, which just makes her even stronger. It's there, it's going to be quite fun. It looks like she one punches hatches. So in regards to if you were using her for a roam, you don't need to worry about bringing a secondary sort of shotgun pistol or rotates, impact grenades to get through hatches. You can just sort of punch a hatch and drop down and get through. The animation does look a little bit faster than a knife as well. I don't know if its range is more. It looked it on one of their melee kills that that there was in that video then. So I hope that's not the case, because you don't want any operator that's got a significant advantage at doing the same thing as another operator unless it is part of their utility. So again, we'll just have to sort of wait and see how she plays. And if she is too strong, then I imagine something like that will be sort of nerfed or even taken away from her in full. The last thing as well, my only worry with her is that you are really, really going to have to work as a team to get through her. Now, that's not a bad thing necessarily. Again, anything where you have to work with your teammates to accomplish something in this game is a pro for me. That's the whole point of this game. It is very team orientated. However, just for example there, one of them clips, I think it was an IQ or somebody, she had like 19 health and she didn't have any more utility. So that operator right there, for example, has the option of walking through the laser gate to die, because it takes 40 damage from what I can see, especially off maybe three speed operators. It takes 40 damage and she was on 19 there, so she actually can't walk through that. She has no projectiles or flashes or anything to get through it and disable it. So the only option she would have there is to rotate round and completely leave pushing that side at all because of her health if she didn't have anyone to help her. So I don't want it to be so strong that it massively affects the way the attacking team work. You should still be able to push an objective the way that you want to push it, and her laser gates are just another added extra that you have got to get through. So again, she looks very, very, very strong. In my personal opinion, maybe a little bit too strong to start with for everything that she's got in regards to weapons, utility, her gadget is amazing. So we'll have to sort of wait and see on her. But from my point of view, as of right now, just the reveal trailer, she looks very, very strong.
Operation Neon Dawn is also bringing a new map rework for Skyscraper, in which they lowered the balcony count in order to lower the body count of defenders being shot from attackers kicking it outside the building. And there's also been some interior work on new connectors and bombsite tweaks. A few gameplay updates are inbound as well, notably the Habana update I mentioned earlier. She can now toggle her gadget to shoot 2, 4, or 6 explosive pellets, so hatches beware. You'll also notice that Echo's yokai drones are now always visible, so you'll know where your splitting headaches are coming from. And Jaeger's ADS gadget now operates a bit differently. The ADS will now take out one projectile and then need to recharge before zapping another. Also, for defenders who like a good run out now and then, please note that the reveal timer has been shortened and step lively. Some improvements to diffuser planting and gadget placement interactions round out the list of gameplay updates that will be free for all players when Operation Neon Dawn launches. The Skyscraper map rework will also be free, and Aruni will be available at launch for all Year 5 pass holders. Everyone else can unlock her 7 days later for Renown or R6 credits.
So guys, that really sort of rounds off all the extra updates and things like that for this new season. So first of all, Skyscraper rework, which is amazing. Like I said, we need another map or two thrown into the rotation. So, and like I said, I didn't personally mind too much the old Skyscraper. So if they've massively improved on it, then great. It'll be a new map to get to know and get to work out and get thrown into the rotation to mix it up a bit more, which again, I'm always down for. In regards to a couple of other things, Habana has got, I don't know why this was never a thing to start off with, Habana has got a buff where she can now choose between 2, 4, and 6 of her ex-Kairos. So again, she doesn't have to waste 6 on a whole hatch, for example. She can just pop 4 off in it, keep 2 as spare for something else, another peek hole, line of sight, things like that. So that's a massive buff to Habana, which was much needed, and I don't know why that wasn't in there from the start. You've got Jaeger, who's been nerfed. Now his ADS, instead of catching 2 projectiles, it actually catches 1 every 10 seconds. So it's got infinite charges, which I suppose is the positive of it. But the absolute negative is that all you need to do now is if you throw 1 flash in and you know there's only 1 ADS there, you can just jump in straight away, or you can then throw your nade in or something like that. And 10 seconds is quite a long window of time as well before it resets. So again, bit of a nerf to Jaeger. I don't know if anyone's going to complain about that too much. Also, there's an extra couple of things. I know some operators have also lost and gained a bit of utility. I think shields have been taken away from Valkyrie, for example. Also, Echo's been gained a shield. So there is some sort of swap rounds and things like that of utility and equipment, which maybe we'll have a look at when the season actually gets underway. But probably the other main one is Echo has been massively nerfed. So the invisibility cloak of his drone is not a thing anymore, ever. whether that's on the floor, it's stuck to a ceiling, no matter what or where it is, it's never ever going to be invisible again now. So it's not going to make him completely useless. I'm sure people will find good little places to hide his drone, and then when a plant's going down, they'll pop it up and stun. So again, I don't think this is going to make him absolutely useless, and again, I don't think the dev team would have made that change if they thought it was going to make him useless. Again, I know they give him a shield and things like that, so sort of giving him a bit of his sort of his work back. But yeah, that is a massive nerf to Echo, and like I said, you won't have that worry now. If you're in a 1v1, you'd have to run an objective and worry about where the Echo drone is. If it's there, you'd probably be able to see it if they're not hiding it. So again, makes it a bit more interactive in regards to defensive operators playing Echo, going to have to do a lot more to try and be smarter with using that Echo drone now. And probably the last thing, which I am very, very excited about, because I'm not a massive defensive operator that runs out and goes for peaks on outside of the building, is that the reveal time has dropped from 3 seconds to 1 second. So now if a defensive operator is outside the building for a second, they get revealed. So some of these runouts, some of them will still be viable, of course they will, especially on a map, for example, like Consulate, running out of yellow stairs to peek onto main windows, that's still going to be viable because it takes a second or less to sort of make that run out and do that peek, so that's still going to be viable. But some of the more annoying runouts, for example, that a defensive operator is really running quite far outside the building to get a peek onto spawn or something like that, that's going to be a lot less viable now, even more so impossible, because instead of having that 3 whole seconds, you've got 1 second, you're outside 1 second, boom, people can see you. So for me, that's a positive. I love that change. Again, just because that's not my kind of gameplay or style anyway. And if you ever do die from them really long, annoying runouts, it is annoying as well. So again, that's probably a massive positive for me going forward for the new season as well. I do love that change. So right, guys, I hope this video was informative and helped you guys out. Thank you so much for watching. If you did like it, leave a like and comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel and make sure you turn that notification bell on, just so you don't miss any upcoming videos in the future in regards to Rainbow Six Siege or any of the other games I have on my channel. And I'll see you in the next one. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Bye-bye.